I awoke after another earthquake and realized, to my horror, that I was the serpent. I transformed at night, but had no memory of it in the morning. I hid in this cave to protect Celestis and its people. During the day, while the serpent slept, I studied all I could about the curse and my transformation. I learned that it grows stronger by feeding on human sorrow. I'm sure the scientists can help find a cure, but it's nearly impossible to get to their island since the bridge has been destroyed. I'm afraid I won't make it to the next transformation.
Oh, hello, Aurora. As you can see, the alley of the artist and its inhabitants are also cursed. I can't distinguish colors, and all my blueprints were lost. Are you looking for scientists? The earthquakes have covered the city in rubble, and it's easy to get lost. I could show you the way if you help me find my blueprints. You should check my studio on the second floor. You'll need this elevator key to get up there. Unfortunately, some of its parts are missing, but they should be around here somewhere. You got it working. That's the first good news we've had in a long time. I hope the blueprints are up there. Here's a key I found in the alley after everyone fled. It might come in handy. How did you like the elevator? It's one of my last prototypes. I was really into engineering before the curse. The blueprints should be here somewhere. I can't rebuild Celestis without them. And of course, I'll help you find your way to the island of scientists.
They must be around here somewhere.
We have the blueprints, but I still can't tell colors apart. How could I have forgotten? I'm sorry, Aurora, but I need your help again. This redevelopment project is the only chance to put the city back together. We need paints. I'm sure I saw some on the roof. Here, this will help us get there.
The paints must be around here somewhere. Five colors should do it. Finding them may not be easy, though. It's a real mess in here. I still can't believe that Victor is a serpent. I hope the scientists can find a cure and end this curse. Don't worry. The fox knows these tunnels well. Your friends will be all right. We have to focus on painting the blueprints. I'll meet you downstairs. This is the oldest bridge in Celestis. Nobody remembers its proper name, so we just call it Old Bridge. This is one of the tallest buildings in the city. We call it the Aurora Tower. It was named after you, of course. The observatory was a source of pride and scientific discovery before the curse fell upon the city. This is our famous well. We have the cleanest water in the area. People from all over the world can see and admire our sunrise. This is my favorite place in town. It's where I first met Victor. A scientist named Dominic lived in his house. He watched the stars from his room at night. I don't recall designing such a statue, but I like it. This flag has flown over our central square for as long as I can remember. This is the greenhouse where Astra works. I hope the foxes led them to safety. Our philosophers gathered and debated under the shadow of this tree. Victor and I designed this fountain when the city... Unbelievable! The curse is gone. I can see colors. I'll show you the way to the scientists. Let's go. I drew this map for you. Follow this road and you won't get lost. The bridge to the scientist's island is located near the home of our herald, William. He will help you if you need anything. Please be careful. I've heard about a madman in town calling himself the King of Celestis. I should be going. Celestis won't rebuild itself. I hope to see you again under better circumstances.